Welcome to the Blazor Scheduler tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to add the Syncfusion Blazor Scheduler component in a Blazor web app. To begin, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a new project from the dashboard. Choose the Blazor web application from the list of project templates and then provide the project name and location. I am using .NET 8 as the framework for this project. Apart from this option, there are four other options for choosing interactive render modes. To learn more about interactive render modes, check out the video linked in the YouTube card above. Now create the project of interactive mode as server where interactive components use a signal-lar connection to communicate with server. Furthermore, I'll continue with the project creation with global interactivity location. When I click the Create button, the project creation will start. The application is now ready to use. Let's open the Solution Explorer and navigate to the program CS file. You notice a method called addInteractiveServerComponents being called. This method adds services to support rendering interactive server components. Additionally, addInteractiveServerRenderMode method is called to configure the server render mode for the app. Next, I navigate to the AppRaiser component, which serves as the root component of the Blazor application. In this file, you can see that the render mode is assigned as interactive server within the routes and head outlet component. Next, I will show you how to add the Syncfusion Blazor Scheduler component to a Blazor web app. First, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor Schedule NuGet package into my application. So I open the NuGet package manager, switch to Browse tab, search for Syncfusion Blazor Schedule, with install the latest version. I also install the latest version of Syncfusion Blazor themes to host the CSS files. After completing the installation, I navigate to the imports Razor file and include the Syncfusion Blazor schedule namespace, allowing me to utilize the Blazor scheduler component within the pages folder. Next, I open the program CS file and add the necessary namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion Blazor service in Blazor web app. Afterward, I need to reference the CSS file in the application to work on the Blazor scheduler component. Therefore, navigate to the AppRaiser component and refer to the CSS file from the installed package. I also include the script reference here. Now that everything is configured, let me proceed to add the Syncfusion Blazor schedule. For that, I open the Home Razor component and replace the default code and define the Syncfusion Blazor scheduler component. I plan to display appointment data within the Blazor scheduler component. I add a code block. Within the block, I'll define a model class named appointment data. Inside the class, I add the appropriate fields like ID, subject, start time, and end time. Then I set the tValue property to bind the appointment data class. This property is used to specify the type of the data that will be bound to the scheduler component. Then I create a list of appointment data objects containing two appointments with specified details. Then I define the schedule event settings tag and set the data source property to bind the appointment data list specifying the data source for the schedule events. Afterward, I initialize the date time variable named current date with the date set to February 2, 2024. Then I set the selected date property to bind the current date variable. Then I define the schedule views tag. This tag contains the list of different views for the Blazor scheduler component, including day, week, workweek, month, and agenda. Now I am planning to display the appointments in the week view alone, so let me set view property as week inside the schedule view tag. Finally, I set the height of the Blazor Scheduler component to 650 pixels. Let's run the example application. You can see the scheduler successfully rendered with provided appointments. When checking the browser and going to the console, notice that the WebSocket is connected to the local host. The server listens for incoming WebSocket connections on a specific port. Next, I will show you how to add the Blazor Scheduler component to the WebAssembly in Blazor Web App. You can follow the project creation steps used for Blazor Web App with Server Interactive Render Mode. For WebAssembly apps, choose WebAssembly Mode. Let's open the Solution Explorer and navigate to the program CS file. You notice a method called addInteractiveWebAssemblyComponents being called. This method adds services to support rendering interactive WebAssembly components. Additionally, addInteractiveWebAssemblyRenderMode method is called to configure the WebAssembly render mode for the app. Let's open the AppRaiser component, which serves as the root component of the Blazor application. In this file, you can see that the render mode is assigned as interactive WebAssembly for the routes and head outlet component. The next step to add the Syncfusion Blazor Scheduler component. I already included the Syncfusion Blazor Schedule and Themes NuGet package into my application and registered the Syncfusion Blazor service in the program CS file on the server side. Additionally, ensure that you check the program CS file on the client side to register the Syncfusion Blazor service. Now everything is configured. Open the home Razor file. Here, I've already added the Syncfusion Blazor Scheduler component. Running the example application, you can see the scheduler successfully rendered with provided appointments. When inspecting the browser and navigating to the console, notice that the .NET runtime and app bundle are downloaded to the client in the background. Next, I will show you how to add the Blazor Scheduler component to Auto Mode in the Blazor Web App. You can follow the project creation steps used for Blazor Web App with Server Interactive Render Mode. For both Server and WebAssembly apps, choose Auto Mode. Let's open the Solution Explorer and navigate to the program CS file. You'll notice the utilization of both render modes. Open the AppRaiser component. This file shows that the render mode is assigned as interactive auto for the routes and head outlet component. Moving on to the home Razor file. Here, I've already added the Syncfusion Blazor Scheduler component. Running the example application, you can see the scheduler rendered with provided appointments. When inspecting the browser and navigating to the console, notice that the WebSocket is connected to the local host. The server listens for incoming WebSocket connections on a specific port. Next, the .NET runtime and app bundle are downloaded to the client in the background. This process involves downloading the necessary assemblies and seamlessly transitioning to work entirely on the client side. Now, let me summarize. I covered how to add Blazor Scheduler component in Blazor Web App. Also, I showed how to interactive render modes in Blazor Web App. For more information on the scheduler features, check out the documentation link provided in this video's description. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.